What's good, YouTube? Chase Vickers back with another reaction video. Today, we're here with Why Larry Bird is Underrated. Now, this one really caught my eye. Because it's like, underrated Larry Bird? But if you really think about it, right? When you hear people talk about, let's just say, top five all time, right? You usually hear, what? Kobe, LeBron, MJ, Wilt, maybe KD, Curry, Tim Duncan, Hakeem. You hear a whole bunch of people, but not many people put Larry Bird in there. Even though we know now that he was very, very, very good. But people just don't give him, I guess you could say, the credit that he deserves. So we are here to see why people do that. And if it's the things that you object to, go ahead and put them in the comments below. And write down the subscribe notification about the like button. And let's get this one underway. 7 minutes and 31 seconds. Well, minus 17 because I just skipped the intro. Because why? It was just like a little basketball of like a whole bunch of different current NBA players. It was his intro, so I just skipped it so we could
get right. It is widely accepted that Larry Bird is one of the greatest NBA players of all time and even sneaks his way into the GOAT debate among many basketball circles. The thing is, I personally rank Larry Bird higher than most people do, as he's currently sitting in the 6th spot on my all-time list.
What, bro? Six. He's either one or two. Because it's either MJ at one or Larry at one or MJ at two or Larry at two. You either have one and another one or the other. It's that simple. But six is crazy.
And I even have him ranked slightly ahead of Magic Johnson, which is certainly a more uncommon opinion. I think there's some major misconceptions to Bird's game that result in him not getting quite as much credit as I believe he deserves. And by the end of this video, I think that I can convince some of you that Larry Legend is in fact underrated. Before we get into some misconceptions, let's start with what most people already know about Bird, and I'll elaborate upon it.
Over his
13-year career, Larry averaged 24.3 points on a stellar 56.4 true shooting percentage. Despite their talent-heavy history, Bird is the Celtics' all-time leading playoff scorer. So whether it was in the regular season or the postseason, he was always an efficient and lethal threat.
I was about to say, well then who's their leading scorer in general, but isn't it Bill Russell? Well, I mean, I don't know if it is. I'm guessing, but if I had to take a guess, it would be Bill Russell. Let me know down below.
He was obviously a legendary scorer and an incredibly efficient shooter. Larry is objectively one of the greatest three-point shooters of all time, as he's tied with Craig Hodges for the most three-point contests won in a career with a total of three. Hodges participated in a total of 8 three-point competitions, while Bird only participated in a total of 4. So he literally did the same amount of damage as the other all-time leader in half the amount of time. On top of all of this, you really could make the argument that Bird is the most all-around efficient scorer of NBA history.
Slaughter.
If that seems like a stretch, then consider this. During some of his prime years, Larry went on a 5-year stretch where he had 50-40-90 percentages. Only 9 players in NBA history have achieved at least one season of 50-40-90 percentages. Yet Larry did it over a 5-year stretch while putting up just about 28-10-7 each night. The only player all-around efficiency over such a long period of time is actually Steve Nash. But the thing is, Nash was never primarily a scorer and averaged roughly half the amount of points that Larry did during his stretch. To efficiently score that many points on that kind of volume of all-around shot attempts is something that no one else has ever done as well as Larry Bird did.
Facts.
Again, maybe some of you didn't know the extent of how lethal Larry was as an all-around efficient scorer, but I do feel like that's probably the most commonly understood aspect of his game. Now for the misconceptions and the details that definitely make Larry an underrated player.
Let's see.
There are a lot of people, especially younger basketball fans, who believe that Larry was a subpar defender. This is incredibly inaccurate, as Bird wasn't just a good defensive player, but a great one. As a 6'9 small forward, he definitely had the size and length to frustrate the offensive opponent.
For sure.
Sure, there is the narrative that Larry was a slow and unathletic player, and thus it affected his defensive play. This is true to a certain extent, but it's also grossly exaggerated. what Larry did have are the most important.
Was it my first reaction video I did to Larry Bird where I said that he was unathletic and slow? I think it was. Because I think I was talking about like his dribble moves. Or his ball handling, where I was talking about how his ball handling isn't good because he's slow and he does it all unathletic. And a lot of y'all came at me in the comments for that. I'm not going to lie.
Important traits of a great defensive.
After the time that we have been watching all these videos of Larry Bird, he made me regret what I said, so I'm not going.
Player, which are hustle, heart, intelligence, effort, and availability. Larry was never lacking in any of these areas. Ew. He always put in the work, and he was incredible, not only at reading the defenses, but also at anticipating them. Larry made three NBA all-defense teams throughout the course of his career, and even finished as high as third overall in the Defensive Player of the Year running in 1983.
He wasn't just
a solid on-ball and help defender, but he was also a terrific pickpocket. As Larry averaged a fantastic 1.7 steals per game over the course of his 13-year career. His best evening in this area came on February 18th, 1985 against the Utah Jazz when Larry dropped 30 points, 12 rebounds, 10 assists, and 9 steals in only...
Dang! In three quarters, he almost had a quadruple-double? Yo!
Three quarters of play. Due to them absolutely destroying the Jazz, Bird didn't play a second of the fourth quarter.
Yo,
to this day,
I'd have threw him in there just to get that quadruple-double, I'm not gonna lie.
The NBA record for the most steals in a single game is 11. So not only could he have easily been only the second player to ever achieve the quadruple-double, but if Bird had played the fourth, he might have been the record holder for the most steals in a game.
100% he would have broke the record.
You have to be a great defensive player in order to be in a position to seize that record. On top of all of that, Bird led the entire NBA in defensive win shares a total of 4 times. That's the 4th most in NBA history. The only players ahead of him on that list are Tim Duncan, George Mikan, and Bill Russell. That is a remarkably short list of great defensive players.
Fact.
I'm not trying to say that Bird was on the level of someone like Dennis Rodman or Scottie Pippen. But to call Larry anything other than a great defensive player is either completely ignorant or is just plain disrespect towards his game. The other key area where people underappreciate Bird was his rebounding ability, as Larry was simply one of the greatest rebounding small forwards that the game has ever seen.
Yep.
He was aggressive and tenacious as he got as high as 11 rebounds per game in 1983.
Oh, dang.
Qualities that I mentioned earlier, like his size, hustle, and intelligence, helped him as he battled on the boards. Over the course of his career, Larry averaged a whopping 10 rebounds per game. And when he was starting specifically at the small forward position, he averaged 9.5 rebounds per game. That's the third highest average among primary small forwards in NBA history. The only players ahead of him are Billy Cunningham and Elgin Baylor, who both played in the 1960s, which was easily the most inflated rebounding era of basketball history. So not only is Bird an underrated rebounder, not only is he objectively one of the all-time great rebounders, but he's also arguably the greatest rebounder ever at his position. Along with all the other skills I talked about, Larry was also a remarkably gifted facilitator.
We know that for sure.
Because like his shooting, I also think that's an area that a decent amount of people have a strong appreciation for. Ultimately, I think it's a solid defense and his elite rebounding that people underestimate. Which is why I think he's underrated, regardless of the fact that people still refer to him as Larry Legend. Do you agree? Where does Larry Bird rank on your list of the greatest players of all time? Let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching as always. Make sure to like and subscribe for more basketball content, and I'll see you guys in the next video.
Let me know where y'all have Larry Bird on y'all all-time list. Me personally, like I said, I have him at 2 behind MJ, and I feel that it will forever be that way for me. But that video right there it had a lot of stuff that I didn't know, that I did not know about Larry Bird, like all of his averages for his career and what the 4-time, what was it? It was defensive win share, right? And then the all defensive teams, the rebound. He literally, Johnny Arnett literally broke down every little well, what do you call it? Topic, I guess you could say. He went from points, rebounds, to steals, to assists. And literally told you why he was the greatest at those. Like, that is, at least for his position, because when it came to rebounding and defense, right? He said, of course, he's not Dennis Rodman or Scottie Pippen, because those two are great defenders. And we know Dennis Rodman is the greatest rebounder of all time. We know that. But this was a beautiful video. So let me know what y'all thought of this video down below in the comments below. Like I said, do I think... Johnny said that his goal was to make us... was to convince us that he is underrated. And I'm not going to lie. I think he really did tell me that he was underrated. Because he really does not get the credit that he deserves. He really doesn't. Like, even Johnny had him at 6. At 6 on his list. Like, 6 is kind of crazy. But hey, let me know what y'all thought of this video down below in the comments below. Why, down in the upload, just drop me direct to also subscribe and notification bell, the like button. And with that being said, stay cool, stay safe, and I love y'all.